Hi, you have found Rides with Chuck. I couldn't have cut it any closer, but this is the B-17E Desert Rat Tangerine 2021 update, and it's all good. Quick question came up.
Yes.
How many flying B-17s are there? How many static display? How many projects are there? The numbers keep changing.
It keeps changing, and I couldn't tell you for sure, but there's probably only about 8 to 10 that can fly. The rest are static. I think they listed about 49 of them are left.
Okay.
There was that many.
Yeah. And I think the Air Force, if I remember right, they own 16 or 17 of those.
Oh, wow. Well,
two or three in Georgia. And then Oregon, and then
Liberty Bell. That's five.
We got Paul Allen's.
Paul Allen's. That's
so,
six.
Yeah, there's probably six, maybe seven if you're stretching it, depending on what you're starting with.
So left or right, these are opposite. You know, so we got three of these and one of these.
So this one.
Yep. And then the other one.
Is up there.
So we have three of these guys.
So we need one more.
Is a dash one on there?
Yeah, this is a left because it doesn't have a dash one. So,
looks like we need a left.
We need one more left.
Or one with no dash numbers. We just need the part number. And what's weird is we came up with this yesterday. We're trying to figure out where that goes in a nacelle, and,
yeah.
there's already one in there. So I don't know if we had picked up a spare that I don't remember, but that was with the right wing stuff. But we pretty much got all the right wing stuff sorted out now.
So, dash one.
No, we need no dash.
Alright. Chris has been our find-it guy. He finds all this stuff.
I don't know how lucky I am.
How do you start looking for something like that?
Well, I do the crazy thing of just going on eBay first to see if I can find anything, and then I just end up putting if we need a part. If we have a picture of it, a part number for it, I put it out on Facebook to a whole bunch of different groups, hoping that somebody, I got one, kind of thing like that. Then I talked to a couple other groups, like Mike will put me in contact with some of the other B-17 groups, and I'll reach out to them and say, hey, do you have any of this, do you have any of that? So sometimes people have it, and they want a lot. Sometimes people have it and they want a little, or some people don't want to let it go. So.
How many times do they have it and it looks like the right thing, but it's not?
Probably more times than you want to say. So, but
we've also been reaching out to museums.
Yeah,
we're finding a lot of museums are getting rid of stuff, sometimes they'll have a few B-17 parts within stuff that they're getting rid of.
If it's a static display, they could actually take it off.
In the day, everybody wanted a B-17, and a lot of museums that do not have a B-17 were gathering parts, thinking they'll get one, and then they realize that's never going to happen.
Uh-huh.
So now they're letting all the stuff go.
And a lot of these places don't, they don't know what they have.
Yeah,
that's
the biggest problem.
They've got a warehouse full of parts, and they don't know,
what's in
a
there?
B-17 part from a B-24 part, So
a lot of times it's about timing too.
Yeah.
It's like you reach out and you got a guy that's like, we were just going through our parts and we found a whole bunch of this stuff or a whole bunch of that, and would you like it?
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of times it's luck and timing.
Yep. All right, are we gonna do some riveting today?
Yeah.
All right.
Show them that part we just got.
You can do the honors. This is a new part Chris had found. It was wrapped in its original stuff still. That's for the cow flap controls.
Where it just came from.
Uh-huh.
So that is pretty nice.
I don't know. But we have the same part.
And here is a brand new handle
So we don't know which one, but it's a hand crank, so it's either for the landing gear or for the bomb bay or for the flaps.
Well, I'm sure they have one. This is the 16.
The hand crank.
Yeah. Every system had an emergency.
Yeah.
We got it from
hand crank system. So.
Yeah, I saw Memphis Bell. Oh, okay.
So it's still in Cosmoline and everything.
That's cool.
Wrapped up, so.
Now, where does something like that come from?
Where did you find it? This was on eBay, wasn't it?
You found that on eBay. Yeah. You guys looking at that and then said, hey, can you grab it?
Yep. If I happen to see something, occasionally I'll surf eBay too. And
you got to figure out what they're called.
Do you grab it even if you don't really need it? Just so.
If it's better than what we have sometimes. Yeah. Otherwise, no, because we're always trying to conserve funds. Sometimes we've had to pass up on stuff we need and want, but we just couldn't afford it at the time, and that hurts. But, so.
Okay.
There's the bullets, huh?
The cowl. Cowl and
engine nacelle.
Pardon?
Engine nacelle. This is engine nacelle number 3. We originally started off trying to restore it on the wing, and it was just too difficult, so we decided to take it off the wing. This one had some fairly heavy damage on it, so we decided to pretty much take it 100% apart and repair and replace what's needed, and we're now in the process of putting it back together. Engine nacelle number 3 is the one that has landing gear in it, so it's a pretty robust structure, and it's finally coming back together. This is engine nacelle number 4, so both these come off the right wing. This one will be done next.
That one looks pretty much together.
A lot more intact, yes. It's got some damage on the firewall and a few dings here and there, so it won't be too bad. It should be easy compared to the first one.
What's the next big challenge?
For as far as challenges go, the next biggest one is getting wing spar tube replacement sections made. We're trying to get a tube that nobody can make anymore, I guess. They said they got rid of all that technology to China. It's a drawn tube that tapers on the inside. And that's probably our next biggest hurdle. We also have gotten a couple of our new tubes from our sponsors. We've just started fitting the lower one.
What is this again?
Carry-through spar tube. So
this is what you've been...
Yeah, these are new terminal plates that go on the end of these, and the wing then slides. There's two of those, and the wing slides in between there and then bolted on. So it's what holds the wings on.
Yeah. So that problem is solved?
Yes.
All right.
Yep. So that just needs the time to get it done and get it installed now.
But it's here, so that's...
So it's here, yep. We're still waiting for the stuff for bulkhead 4. There's another set of this stuff that goes on that bulkhead. But I'm sure they'll get that done here eventually.
What's
Yep, that's the instrument panel.
Not a dashboard?
No. That's car terms. Yeah, this is the instrument panel for a stock E, which this would have had. It may end up being modified, or we actually have other panels that have more slots for instruments, but when we get into setting up that, we'll make a determination of what we're going to use. This is another tube. It's a new one and old that came from the same place. We just haven't put this one in yet.
Real nice Christmas present.
Yes. Yes, it is.
And?
Well, We've been trying to declutter the place. We're slowly getting rid of a lot of the things we don't need, even some of the models and stuff. If we get an opportunity, we keep trying to sell stuff off, mm-hmm. you know, so we can put the money into the airplane.
So you must be putting stuff on eBay too.
Not eBay so much, but pretty much everything else that we can use. You know, there's local let go, offer up, and then there's a Wix, a Warbird information exchange on the internet, so we go through there and use them to also identify stuff that we don't know what it is. So we got a lot of parts to other airplanes that we have no idea what it goes to. Sometimes when you want one thing, you have to buy 10 just to get that one thing, and then you got to find a home for that the other 9 things. But anyway, these are vertical braces that go in between the two steel spars that will be new.
Okay. That's all made here?
Yes. And it's been slower for us with these last couple of years on volunteers, too. We've had a noticeable drop in... I don't know what you've filmed before.
Well, you know, everything is different every time I come here. It's a little bit different than...
These are all pieces out of the interior of the right inboard wing. All this stuff has been refurbished. You know, once we get the wing box done, then all that stuff will be reinstalled.
Yep,
we got all of it identified, where it goes and all that now. So this is the tail gun compartment. Close, but not quite done. But Chris got the sight hooked up to the guns, so it moves, you know, in conjunction with them, just like it did back in the early 40s. So...
Like this was curved in different ways.
Yeah, this was done with like an English wheel or a plunishing hammer. Sometimes they use both. Uh-huh. So. This is the left wing, and we decided to leave it intact until we get the right wing done. And turned out to be a good idea. It's really handy to go look at this and, you know, makes it a lot clearer of what's going on in the other wing. Uh-huh. So. This is a 1942 Jeep. We haven't worked on that in the last year or so, but we were on that for a while. But we'll be getting back on that. We're looking for a Go Devil engine for it. Our engine that came with it has quite a few cracks in it, so... They didn't recommend repairing it. These are the outboard wings. And they haven't had much progress here in the last year or so. We got them down. These are kind of waiting until we can figure out how to make corrugation. Because we need quite a bit of new corrugation to put on these.
And you can make corrugation here?
I don't think so. We don't have the equipment right now. We've looked at getting it, but there is a place in Woodstock that has what they call a press brake, which is what you would need to make this stuff. It's just not quite as long as we'd like it to have. I think he only has 8 or 10 foot capacity. And in a perfect world, we'd like to get about a 14 foot capacity. So. We'll see what's going to happen with that. All right. Thank you.
started out Desert Rat, and it also became Tangerine.
Yes.
What happened?
Desert Rat was visible through the outside layer of paint, so we knew it had a name on there and had been using it. But then once we got to restoring the nose and stripping the paint, we found a second name that was on there first, and that was called Tangerine. And it's in the script, just like was typical of the really early B-17s. So we'll probably put one on one side and one on the other. Since this carried both names during World War II.
You have to.
Yeah.
Good, okay. That's good.
It's yourairplane.com. He's been sponsoring us for about 10 years and helping us sell extra stuff that we have to raise, you know, raise even more funds. So, yeah, he makes a lot of reproduction stuff.